Good morning students, welcome to mathematics class. Dear students, now today we are going to discuss how to subtract the 5 digit number, okay, with borrowing. How to take the borrow, we have to discuss today. Now last video, we discussed how to subtract 5 digit number without borrow. Okay, see here, I am going to take one example. Subtract, read the number, you need 10, 100, 1000, 10,000. 67,258 from 86,040. Okay, for subtraction, first you have to learn which number we have to take. Okay, see, here we are going to subtract, 67,258 from which number? From the number 86,040. Therefore, children, you have to write first as this number. Okay, you can write 86,040. Okay, minus in this number, we are going to subtract 67,258. That's why I wrote minus 67,250. Dear children, some students, what they will do means they will write first this number they will write. No, it's the wrong. Compulsory first we have to write this number because we are subtracting this number from 86,014. Okay, now it is the actual result. And one more thing I will tell you. From is the right after from. After from which number is there? That number you have to write first. Is it clear up? Fine. Now first for subtracting these numbers. First, I am going to denote the place values. That is ones, tens, hundred, thousand, 10,000. It is a very important. Okay. Now, dear children, you know the properties of subtraction. Okay, the properties of subtraction. Always, first we have to subtract ones. See here also, I am going to subtract ones. See children, what is the number it is? The number is 4 and we have to subtract 8. Is it possible to subtract 8 here? No, because 4 is a lesser number, 8 is a bigger number. It's not possible to subtract. For that reason, we have to take 1 borrow from 10. In 10, how many numbers are there? One number is there. I'm going to take this 1 as borrow here. Then 4 becomes 14 and this 1 becomes 0. Is it clear now? Where this 1 goes? This 1 goes here. What I did? I am taken 1 as the borrow. Okay. See that it becomes 14. Now 14 minus 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. That is 14 minus 8 is 6. Are you understood, children? Now, in tens, what is the number remaining? 0. 0 minus 5, is it possible? No, it is not possible. That's why, again, I am going to take here. Again, I am going to take 1 as the carry. I am going to take here 1 as the carry. Then it becomes 10. Then 0 becomes 9. Okay, now. What I did, I am going to take here 1 carry, then it becomes 10. 10 minus 5 is equals 5. In 100, it becomes 9. Now tell me, 9 minus 2 is how much here? 9 minus 2 is 7. Okay, and this 6 becomes 5. Is it possible to subtract 7 here? No. Again, we have to take 1 borrow from 10,000 place. See, I am going to take 1 borrow, then it becomes 15 and this 8 becomes 7. Okay, now 15 minus 7 is how much? 15 minus 7 is 8. Okay, and 7 minus 6 is 1. Therefore, the final answer is 18,756. Is it clear, children? How to subtract this type of sums? Fine. Now I am going to take one more sum. Now the sum is here. Find the difference Okay, now first, as I told you, first I am going to subtract the ones. In ones, what is the number? 4. And we have to subtract 5. Is it possible to subtract here? No, because 4 is the smaller number and 5 is the bigger number. It's not possible, because always we have to subtract bigger number minus smaller number. Okay, smaller number minus bigger number is not possible. That type of sums we have to take, borrow from tens, hundreds, like this. Okay, now here I am going to take one borrow from tens. In tens we are having the number 3. In 3 I am going to take one as the borrow. Then 4 becomes 14 and 3 becomes 2. 3 becomes what? 2. Because one number we gave to ones, one number we gave to 4, then it becomes 14. Now 14 minus 5, how much 14 minus 5? 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. It is total 9. Okay, now come to the tens. In tens we are having 2 and we have to subtract 6. Again it is possible, children? No. Therefore again we have to take 1 borrow from 8. In 8 I am going to take 1 borrow, then 2 becomes 12. And 8 becomes 7. Okay, now then 12 minus 6. Is it possible to subtract? Yes, because 12 is a bigger number, 6 is a smaller number. 12 minus 6 is how much? 6. Next, come to the 100. Now 7 minus 9. Is it possible to subtract? No, because 7 is a smaller number, 9 is a bigger number. It's not possible. Therefore, again we have to take 1 as the borrow from thousands. We have to take 1 borrow. Here 4 is there. I am taking here 1 as a borrow. Then 7 becomes 17. 4 becomes 3. Okay. Then it becomes 17 minus 9. 17 minus 9. 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. Total it is 8. Okay, next thousands. 3 minus 8, can we subtract 3 minus 8, children? No, it's not possible to subtract, because 3 is the smaller number, 8 is the bigger number. Therefore, again we have to take 1 borrow from 10,000. In 10,000 it is 7. I'm going to take 1 borrow, then 3 becomes 13, 7 becomes 6. Okay, children. Now 13 minus 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, it is 5. Okay, now, next, 6 minus 3 is always equals to 3. That's it. It is our final answer. Are you understood, children? Fine. Now, next video, I am going to solve few more sums about this only. Okay, children? You have to write these sums in your classwork, and at the same time you have to practice this in your homework notebook. Thank you.